Warning, the following video will offend e-beggars because it contains the truth.
Let's face it, if you are unwilling to support yourself and create your own money, you have to obviously have somebody else give you theirs. Therefore, as a public service to the e-begging community, which I have been a party to observe, I'm going to help you guys all out. Now, there is some preparation work you must do. First of all, you must put aside all pride and self-respect. Just throw it out the window, because you ain't going to be needing that anymore. And second of all, you need to practice your skill and art of lying. And I'm going to give you some tips to remember the lies. Now, remember, online e-begging is a long scam for the most part. Because after all, as we know, scam them once, feed yourself once. Scam them for life, feed yourself for life, as the saying goes. You're going to also need a cute dog or cat. It always helps. Because there's a lot of people out there that love animals, and they're going to give money to you for your animal. But of course, you're going to spend it all on beer. Now, what I mean about the long con is you want to be squeezing money out of people forever. Because after all, you want to travel, so you're going to make somebody else work so they can pay you to do that. The short con is like a fellow I used to work with years ago. His mother died in India 3 times so he could get paid time off work. Now, you want to be conning people over the long haul to keep that money flowing through your pie hole for the rest of your life. Therefore, you need to keep track of all the online e-begging lies that you make. How do you do that? It's simple. You just write it down. Just make a little list called List of Lies, so that way you can remember what you said. Because after all, if you're telling the truth, you don't need to remember it. But if you're lying, you definitely do. So once you get all your lies completely straight, you need to manufacture a crisis moment. Yes, have your transmission go, even, of course, if it didn't go. Because it keeps the money flowing in, because people feel sorry for you. Now, if you are a really skilled thespian, which is just a fancy word for actor, you can practice crying and looking really sad. Multiple sources of income also help. For example, fake a disability and get that disability money coming in with the e-begging money. Now you're talking some serious money. One of the common mistakes of the disability fakers is that they video themselves all the time doing all sorts of physical activities which are contrary to their disability. That's really dumb. So on your list of lies of things you must remember, always remind yourself, hey, I'm faking a disability, so don't video yourself lifting heavy objects if your disability says you can't lift heavy objects, if you follow what I'm saying. Bonus! If you cannot afford a dog or a cat, just borrow one for God's sakes. And then in your next episode, say it died. You also need to conjure up horrible stories of personal tragedy. For example, talk about that uncle that touched you inappropriately when you were a young child. Oh boy, that's good for at least $1,000 worth of donations. Now, a good e-beggar, of course, will stand beside their own BS. So always make sure that list of lies is complete and accurate so that later when you are called upon to testify about your bad behavior, you've got your lies completely straight. Because that's really one of the most important and critical aspects of online e-begging, is getting all the lies correct. Now, ways of creating revenue other than having your dog die repeatedly and your transmission break down repeatedly is to actually just put it right out there that you're hinting for something. I've always dreamed of one day having a 5 Series BMW. You know, just say things like that. Keep in mind, you also must stay on point with current liberal trends. For example, without regard to your dietary habits or your political beliefs, you must be a liberal and you must be a vegan. It's very important to stay on the cutting edge of social trends so that you look like you're a really good guy. Video yourself picking up a piece of garbage and throwing it in a recycling bin. Ooh, you're suddenly a saint. Remember, don't piss off the eco warriors, because they're going to donate to your bullshit cause too. Now, once you're successful and the money is really flowing in, you probably think you don't need any more e-bagging. Well, actually, that's not true at all. What you need to do is start looking scruffier. So the more money you actually generate and the more money you personally have in your bank account, the scruffier and poorer you need to look, therefore enshrining poverty upon the psyche of all your donors so that they perpetually feel sorry for you and the money never stops. Now, when it comes to the scruff factor, looking like a biblical character or a serial killer is the look that you want to go. Big beard, scruffy, dirty hair, don't dye your hair anymore if you're old, you know, all these kinds of things. The rougher you look, the better the income. After all, would you donate money to somebody that looks like they don't need money? Of course not. You need to play the part. Now, y'all wondering how I learned all these tricks? Well, I've learned them just by watching. The Nomad community is the worst, bar none, when it comes to e-bagging. After all, they want you to work so that they don't have to. Unfortunately, the shut-ins, if they actually kept their money, they could travel instead of paying the money for somebody else to travel. So since everybody's getting on the e-bagging bandwagon by the day, I figured I might as well do a video to help newcomers out so they don't waste any time, because I want them to get right at it and just put up the shingle, I am an e-bagger, and get that cash flowing in. After all, why should they fund their own dreams when they can get suckers to pay for their dreams? Hey, so that's the way I see it here, folks. And in the meantime, stay safe, keep your wheels in the ground, and don't e-bag. Got it?